It is 6:01. I'd like to call the meeting of the Somerset Conservation Commission to order at 6:01 p.m. on December 27, 2021. Can we do a roll call of the members present, please?
Matt Tobbe here.
Joe Duart here.
Bonnie Mendes here.
Matt Mara here. And Chip.
There's four sheets here for you guys. Mm-hmm.
Yep. Are you setting something up?
I'm on first?
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah, so what we'll do is we'll hold off the minutes until we do the...
Yep. Yeah, that's fine.
Presentations. Let me read this and then we'll...
Actually, Rich, if there's any way you can set something up over here, because we've got a camera.
Sorry. This order of business is a public meeting on the request for determination of applicability filed by Yanni Maharias Catalyst Architects for work at 54 County Street, consisting of the proposed remodeling of the branch bank and restriping of the parking lot. The entrance drive from County Street will be closed. The existing pavement on the entrance drive will be converted to lawn. The proposed paving will be within 70 feet of the bordering vegetated wetland that is across County and Riverside Avenue. Notice of this meeting has appeared in the local newspaper at least 5 days prior to this hearing. The protocol for this meeting will be to hear from the applicant, then from anyone who wishes to speak on behalf of the petition, after which you will hear from anyone who wishes to speak in opposition to the petition. The commission will then make a decision as to whether or not the area of work is subject to the Wetland Protection Act. If the petitioner is agreed by this decision, he or she has a trust to, as 10 days from the date of issuance of this decision to file an appeal to the state DEP. The determination will be sent to the petition via certified mail to assure timely delivery. Conversely, if any abutter or 10 citizens of the town are agreed to this determination, they also have the right to appeal to the state DEP. However, we do not set determination other than the petitioner. Therefore, we recommend that any abutter or group of 10 citizens wishing to appeal this determination check with the town clerk to be given a copy. This also must be done within 10 days of the issuance of the determination. We will now hear from the petitioner.
Oh, we don't got this. We don't have the same print there. Here it is. Sorry.
So my name is Rich Ferrigal. I'm in the hearing, and we prepared the plan. This is the existing Bank 5 bank with County Street on the left and Riverside at the bottom. There's a 200-foot riverfront area that's shown in blue, and there's a FEMA floodplain AE zone 15 that's running just at the bottom of the property, and I put a little dot here where the actual 15 contour line occurs. That's where the real floodplain is. This is where the FEMA map has it. And this green line is the 100-foot from DDW line. So those three resource buffer zones that are there. And what is being proposed is just minor modifications to the there's currently an entrance.
Can you just hold on 1 second? We just got started like a minute ago.
Okay.
So this is the project down on the corner of Riverside and County where Bank 5 is. And they want to do some renovations, and they want to shift some of their parking around because you've got the river on one side, you've got the brook on the other side. They're here for an RDA.
Okay.
Sorry, Rich. Sorry about that.
So there's a paved entrance drive from County Road right here. It's proposed to just take it out and put grass there. And there's a very narrow landscape that we're going to widen it to a wider green area. We're going to add this green island over here with some shrubbery. And basically the lot will then be scarified. We're just going to skim off top of it and then put down a new paved level on the lot and then restripe it so it's more efficient. And this sidewalk is going to come into the front door.
What are you going to mill it?
Yeah, you mill it down.
Yeah, okay.
And that's it. So the plans just show the details. And on the next plan is erosion control that goes along the bottom here and here. But the slope is from the north southerly this way. But the disruption will be very minor. Basically, they'll mill it down, remove that material, and the following few days they will be coming in and putting it up. So very little disruption of the resource area buffer zones.
Okay. I mean, I'm glad that you're putting a little more green space, which is fine. I'm not going to ask the egress question. Obviously, that's that you've met whatever egress issues as far as like multiple entrances to the property. So that's not ours, our issue anyway. The only thing we need to make sure is any mitigation controls that are in place during the milling process. So that way, either. Silt fences.
Wattles are preferable.
Wattles,
yeah. Okay.
We have an erosion control sheet. It's basically right here showing compost sock and silt fences running around here.
Right.
With erosion control.
Right. And obviously across the entrance when that work is being done.
Right.
Until it's done. Okay. I mean, it's pretty straightforward, but I don't know. Yeah, anyone else on the commission have questions?
Nope.
No. I make a motion.
Anything, Tim? Do we have a file number?
We don't need a file number.
We don't
need a file
number. It's an RDA. Okay.
This is the only
hay bale. So they said hay bale.
Do you
want
to change that to that was the other thing. It says hay bales. The other thing. Do you want to change
15,
it to one?
It says hay bales. Do you want to? On your erosion control notes, you've got hay bales listed.
Okay. So we're not proposing. We're proposing the wattles.
Wattles. Okay.
The compost.
All right.
Sorry.
Okay.
As long as that is reflected.
Just make that motion based on the plans presented.
Should make that based on
for a negative determination.
Yeah, we'll make a motion on that on the wattles.
Okay. I have a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Okay. I'm sorry. I didn't get a chance to ask anybody in the audience if anybody had questions. Okay. All right. Hearing none, I'll call for a roll call vote. Karen?
Karen
Smeagol,
aye.
Okay, sorry. Okay.
So
Karen
Smeagol,
aye.
Matt Talbot, aye.
So Duan,
aye.
Hi, Mindy's, aye.
Buckner, aye. Okay, thank you very much.
I'll get that out to you, James.
And, thank you. 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 Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank you.
Put the print name on there because of my signature.
Oh, jeez.
Next time, I totally get it.
You should get a prop power.
I want to do it in orange. Hey, George.
Good night.
Thank you.
This is how it's got. It's a whole lot of paper.
Thank you. This is what's it got?
Like a
map,
the
okay.
Oh, got this.
Okay.
This is the
end of the line. Okay, let me just start
reading. All right.
So the next order of business is a public meeting on a notice of intent filed by Brian George, 3129 County Street, to redevelop a portion of the existing self-storage facility by eliminating some existing paid surfaces and adding three new freestanding buildings and adding to three existing storage buildings. A redelineation of parking is also proposed. The work is located entirely in a previously developed area and within 100 feet of a bordering vegetated wetland and within a 200-foot riverfront area. Notice of this hearing appeared in the local newspaper at least 5 days prior to this hearing. The protocol for this hearing is to hear from the applicant, then anyone who wishes to speak on behalf of the applicant, after which we will hear from anyone who wishes to speak in opposition to the applicant. All questions will be addressed to the chair. Assuming we have a DEP file number?
We do.
Thank you. And sufficient information, the hearing will be closed and the order issued. If the applicant has agreed to the order of conditions, they have 10 days from the date of issuance to file an appeal with the DEP. If any abutter or 10 citizens of the town are agreed to the order, they also have a right to appeal with the DEP. We recommend you check with the town clerk regularly to see if the order has been written. We will now hear from the applicant. Do you want to identify yourself?
Sure. Good evening, for the record. Steve Giosa with SciTech, Civil and Environmental Consultants. And we're here representing the petitioner, the applicant this evening, NSA Property Holdings. I do have the abutter notification cards.
Thank you.
You can turn in. So as was read into the record, this is a 4.5-acre site, existing commercial site, located on the west side of County Street, just down from the Brook area, just off to the property to the north. And we have essentially the main building situated on the west side of the site. It's about a 57,000-square-foot commercial building, been here for an extended period of time. Pavement that kind of surrounds the building, and in the front of the building there were three self-storage unit buildings that were constructed a number of years ago, and everything surrounding that is fenced in with a paved surface for that existing facility. Supporting the facility, there are some drainage basins on the property, some existing catch basins, and we'll talk about how we're looking to upgrade that a little bit with the modifications we're proposing. But the unshaded structures are shown as existing, so this is existing. Here is the existing self-storage units in the front. And the shading represents the proposed shading is the proposed paved area. And essentially, you've got a site that's about 93%. Make sure I get my numbers right. And 93% lot coverage. We're going to do a little bit of modifications. We can't do a lot because of the required parking requirements, but we're going to eliminate some parking down here in the corner where currently this is paved. We're going to create some landscaping here, some landscaping here, some landscaping here. There is some green space that will be preserved here. So the work will all be within the existing paved surface and within the existing fenced-in area. There will be no expansion of the footprint of the project. And so the differences you'll see if this project is approved is a new freestanding self-storage building, so no change in use. They're just addressing a demand that they feel the market area has for self-storage. So they want to have one freestanding here, a second smaller one here, and then add on three small additions to the existing blocks on the existing storage units. And then finally, a third new building down here on the south side of the property. Access to County Street will remain exactly the same. The access is actually through an easement on the abutting property. You come in through a security gate here, enter the property. That will remain. There is a secondary gate for primarily for emergency access. This gate is typically not utilized by patrons of the facility. We're going to redo some of the parking right now. This kind of parking occurs up in this area here. We're going to stripe out some areas adjacent to the building, have an area where they can have clients or customers load materials into the main building. And then our primary customer parking here, again, the zoning requires a lot of parking. We're actually going to the zoning board looking for a variance so we don't have to expand the parking facility. Not that we have much room to do that. We're maintaining some, again, employee parking in the back. Again, more to meet the zoning requirements. The demand on parking here, 6 or 7 cars at any given point in time. It's really a low-intensity project. But, again, it's within your jurisdiction. We have had a wetlands delineation completed by a wetland scientist. They've hung the flags out here, primarily off the property to the north. Labor and Vane Brook runs through this area here. And so this area corresponds with the bank of the brook as well as the edge of the bordering vegetated wetland. We then have a 100-foot buffer zone from the resource area of the vegetated wetland. And then the 200-foot zone extending from the riverfront area onto the property here. So this lower section of the site falls within your jurisdiction. and the property generally drains down in this direction. Now, when we look at drainage controls on the property, we look at the grading plan, same orientation. There are a series of catch basins in the parking lot, here, here, here. They're all interconnected, here, here. And so the drainage will remain exactly the same. There'll be no change in grades, no redirection of runoff. The water will still collect in those basins, but what we're proposing to do, we've added a notation to the plan. Each of the units, each of the catch basins will be retrofitted with a water quality unit. That water quality unit is a flow guard plus catch basin insert, so it's a basket that sits in underneath the grate. The runoff, the first flush runoff water runs into that. We'll get TSS removal as well as oil and grease removal. They have a little bag, and there's a hydrocarbon absorption unit, carbon absorption, that'll absorb some of the hydrocarbons that do wash off the parking lot. We tend to use these more in these low-intensity use parking lots, so they work really well. We've done a number of Rockland Trust banks, and we've done them for their parking lots, and the maintenance people find them easy to maintain because they just pull the grate off. Everything's right there close to the surface, easy to clean. So you've got a parking lot now that just relies on standard catch basins. We're going to upgrade those all with these flow guard units, and again maintain the same direction of flow. By eliminating the paved surface and replacing it with buildings, we're actually substituting a little bit dirtier water for clean water, because the roof runoff water tends to be a little cleaner. But again, it's a low-intensity parking lot, so we're really not seeing a lot of materials washing off this type of facility. And it's really not going to be a big upgrade to the use of the property. As I said earlier, the general grading is in this direction. We have erosion control starting all the way up here. Even though our limit of real activity ends here, we came a little bit further up gradient of the limit of work. Showed erosion control all the way down along the edge here, and then we're doing a little bit of work below this for this building, so to protect from the street, we are showing erosion control down here and wrapping around the corner here. There really is no other construction activity in the middle, and then we are proposing to use silt sacks during construction for all the existing catch basins for temporary sediment control during the process where we're disturbing a little bit of surface area here, a little bit at the ends of each of these buildings, and a little bit down in this area. Other than that, there'll be no alteration behind the building, on the side of the building. And again, we think with the flow guards after construction, the silt sack and the erosion control measures during construction, I think we meet the performance standards. We do have a DEP file number. If I remember, there were no comments from DEP on the application. And I think that's an overview. One other thing we do have to do, the sanitary line that runs through the property, runs through here, we do have to reroute it around this building. But it does meet proper slope requirements, and we're putting manholes in instead of just cleanouts. So we have good control on that utility, but we're not getting into any new construction work or utility extension out into county. So it's really all within the existing fenced-in area of the site. A little bit of reduction, unfortunately, only about a 1% reduction in lot coverage, but a little bit of benefit there. We think the biggest benefit is with the flow guard units and the water quality improvements that we can implement here. Have you happened to answer
Is the building going to have any sanitary service once you've stopped?
No, none of these buildings will have any sanitary. There's existing sanitary in here, but it won't be changed. There'll be no additions or modifications. They're not looking to add additional staff. It's really just additional storage units, and they don't need, because it's such a limited utilization, they really don't need to add staff to the site. So.
Sure. I think we all remember the old car pallet. So. Mm-hmm. Remember what it looked like in there before. I don't know what it looks like now. So I'm definitely supportive and glad to hear of the erosion control work that you're going to do around the side. A couple of questions I had was maintenance. So what's the maintenance schedule for those? I'm thrilled to hear about the catches that you're going to be putting in there. That's great.
So the catch basins are maintained pretty similar to any other catch basin, although the flow guard units, they recommend at least initially quarterly inspections and cleaning. Normally on a catch basin, you go twice a year, spring and fall. But with the flow guards, because you want to maintain their efficiency, you don't want them to get overloaded. So if we have a mild winter and not a lot of sanding, we're not going to probably have a lot of accumulated sediments in the units. But at a minimum, you want to start out with that quarterly inspection. So we did put that right on the plan under the long-term maintenance program for the site. And again, other than that, it's maintained like any other catch basin. You come in, you vacuum out the basins. That'll also get them to check the basins. We find the biggest problem with commercial sites, you build all these nice things and nobody ever checks them. So here with the flow guard units, it's almost like you have to check them, because if you don't, you'll notice a failure at the surface, because you'll start seeing a little bit of a puddling, and they're not going to want to operate with that happening. So it kind of gives you a little bit of a check if it's not being properly maintained. If you're maintaining it correctly, you'll never see a problem, you'll never see a puddle. And again, we've used these on a lot of bank projects where they are kind of more the lower intensity commercial uses. Mm-hmm. People don't go to banks as much anymore.
Sure.
Yes.
I just have maybe a couple of obvious questions, but the new buildings that are going up are on existing pavement?
Yes, there'll be slab-on-grade construction. There's no basements.
Okay.
Yeah, and we'll just follow the natural topography. So you'll see these existing buildings are all stepped so that we're not building up to one level, that they are working with the natural grades, and that'll carry through for these going down as well.
And the ultimate effluent to the drainage, does it go out to the street?
No, there's an overflow on the existing drainage. I guess it's the historical overflow. Everything collects, comes down, and runs out to the north.
To the brook.
It heads over to the brook, yes.
Yeah. I'm assuming we approved, this is before my time, but we approved the original plan, so there's not a big change. It's, like you said, it's the same. My only question I have, and I know you mentioned it, so up in, the easiest way to say it is the upper right-hand corner. That is parking now,
yes.
But you're going to make it more green.
Yeah, there's pavement all the way up to the fence here. There's the fence line here. So this is getting pulled out. There's pavement all down here. We're pulling that pavement out. And we're pulling out some pavement here and along this strip, and we're pulling out some pavement here.
So there really wasn't much grass to begin with within your fence line.
Within the fence line,
you're adding a few yards.
Where we can, are.
Sure.
Okay. Yeah.
And nothing obviously in the back.
No, nothing's being touched in the back. All we're doing in the back is restriping the parking spaces.
Okay.
But it's following the existing pavement line there.
Right. And you said there were no comments from DEP. Right.
Okay.
Anybody else have any questions?
No.
All right. Does anybody in the audience have any questions? Okay. Hearing none, I'll entertain a motion to close the hearing and maybe a negative issue an order of conditions. Thank you.
So moved.
Matt,
was that you, Matt?
Yeah.
Okay. Do I have a second?
Second.
Thank you. Any additional questions? No? All right. Hearing none. Roll call vote, please.
Karen Smigel, aye.
Brigitte Driscoll, aye.
Matt Talbot, aye.
Joe Duard, aye.
Bonnie Mindy's, aye.
Bob Kamara, aye.
Very good. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Yes. Would you by any chance?
No. I think I might have one in the car. If I do, I'll bring it back in. I always have cards. I didn't bring one.
So you don't.
No, I don't. All right, good idea.
See you again.
See you again.
With the mask.
I know.
Yeah. I don't need you to come back again.
Yeah, okay. I kind of thought I knew who I was, but okay.
Good night. The guy tonight that's like flashing the past.
Good night, folks.
Good night.
Kind of relaxed.
Yeah,
really relaxed. Are we tired yet? January 20th.
CDC is probably the better. He was an abbreviation for the company. It's Sitech Civil and Environmental Consulting.
You remember the marked improvement?
Yes.
So we're part of this company. I'm a senior engineer.
Are we ready? Okay. Moving on. So we have we have three certificates of compliance requests. All of them by Gladdinghurn, and it's all work that's been done, approved. Some of it has been done for quite a while. As you know, we've had certificates of compliance be requested for work that was done 40 years ago. And I called DEP and they said, you've been by. Is there anything changed? I said, no, it looks like whatever they said they were going to do, they did. And she said, it's a fairly safe approval. Mm-hmm. Lately, I can tell you that anybody that's doing any kind of banking, or you want to put your house up for sale, or you need to go get a loan, or you need to do anything, I don't know, including them, I don't know what it is that they're doing. The banks now will not move forward without a certificate of compliance.
Okay.
So if they see something recorded and there's nothing else following it up, then that puts everything on hold, which I believe is what's going on here. Okay. So I'm going to, the first one, you can read that if you want.
Sure.
Read the letter.
Let me read it out loud then. So a certificate of compliance is requested by Childs Engineering, representing Gladdinghurn Shipbuilding, 1 Riverside Avenue, Somerset, Mass., regarding maintenance dredging under Order of Condition 070-0470, issued on March 6, 2015.
Okay, so I have a letter. This one happens to be from, from Childs Engineering, okay, from the DP file number 070-0470, as a project designer and permit agent for the maintenance dredging project at Gladdinghurn Shipbuilding in Somerset, Mass., Childs Engineering has reviewed the project documents and performed site inspection of the completed projects. Based on our observations, we believe that all work was performed in substantial conformance with our plans and specifications and the order of conditions issued by the Somerset Conservation Commission and Mass. DEP on March 6, 2015. Continued maintenance dredging shall be performed under the newly obtained order of conditions with DEP file number 070-0527, which they just came before us not too long ago.
Okay, yep.
For that one. So, Mr. Chairman, there's nothing here preventing the commission from signing off on this certificate of compliance.
So no additional work within the parameters of that original order?
Nope. This work was done. They came back to renew another order of conditions for dredging, only to have this one with no certificate of compliance. So
then the request is for the commission to issue a certificate of compliance.
Correct.
Correct.
Now, where do these get filed? Is this part of the
registry of deeds?
Right. So the order of conditions got recorded.
Yep.
Not unlike most. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's not our job to chase them.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
It spells it right out on the order of conditions that you need to file for a certificate of compliance. Most in the past do not. I'm finding more lately have are coming around.
Okay, so move.
Motion to issue the certificate of compliance.
I'll second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second. Any additional questions?
No.
All right, hearing none, we'll do a roll call vote.
Karen Smigel, aye.
Renee Driscoll, aye.
Matt Talbot, aye.
Joe Duan, aye.
Bonnie Mendes, aye.
Paul Kamara, aye.
The
So just a quick question. I know you're saying that it's their responsibility, but us approving these without checking on them, is there anything that...
You wouldn't be able to check on anything. This particular one is underwater.
Okay. So,
yeah, so this dredging, I remember this. Well, they've come to us a few times.
Mm-hmm. So dredging?
I've been on the board.
Oh, yeah.
And they even the subsequent ones, too, like, you know, we're approving them. Is that normal? Like, it just seems odd that this, like, one here from 1998, like...
Yeah. So what would, and correct me if I'm wrong, Tim, but what would normally happen, Matt, is that we get notified when the work is done.
What should happen
is that we should get notified when the work is completed. But what happens is a lot of them don't ultimately do that. Again, if there was any question on this work, Tim would have obviously had some questions for them. But basically, it's, you know, it's just like either they're refinancing the property, selling the property, whatever it is, they're doing something that requires them to have that certificate of compliance for whatever reason that needs to be recorded for whatever financial transaction, and they just never got around to doing that, and that was the case. And we've done this a few times off the top of my head in the past. It usually has happened most often with houses. You know, if somebody's selling a house and they had a dock put in and never had come to us with a certificate of compliance, now they want to sell it. So now we've done that certificate of...
So Bob, these companies though, that like Childs Engineering, Byron Holmes is up there coming to us saying that, hey, we're certifying that work has been done, we're just asking for your blessing at this point. Like, I just don't want anything to...
When it's something that we can't see, like the dredging and whatnot, yes. But I mean, I know that one of them is for they had put in for a building, and then they came back and asked to make the building a little bit bigger. Yeah. That work has all been done. Mm-hmm. That I can tell you.
What would happen if the engineering firm wasn't in business anymore? Right.
They'd have to hire somebody
else.
They'd
have to hire somebody. It
would be like an after-the-fact type thing.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Are you ready for the next one?
Next one, yep.
Okay.
This one, please.
All right. The next is a request for a certificate of compliance requested by Byron Holmes, PE, representing Gladding Hearn Shipbuilding, 1 Riverside Ave, Somerset, Mass. Regarding an addition to an existing building under order of condition 070-0423, issued on July 30th, 2007.
Okay, on behalf of Judge Duclos, please find, I will tell, I don't know how many of you remember, I think Bob, you might, and Karen probably does too. Do you remember Byron Holmes, when he used to come before us?
I recognize him.
I think you would recognize him if you saw him. Yeah, he came before us fairly often back in the day. On behalf of Judge Duclos, please find and close the request for a certificate of compliance for an order of conditions issued on July 30th, 2007. The notice of intent submitted for this project was for an addition to an existing building. The order of conditions is on file with the Fall River Registry of Deeds and book 6855, page 145. This letter will serve to confirm that the work at this location was completed at the time of the original approval and is in substantial accordance with the approved plan. It is also noted that an earlier order of conditions was issued in 1998 that allowed the construction of the existing building at the site. A separate certificate of compliance is being issued for that project, and that would be the next one.
Yeah. Yep. Okay.
So same thing. They did the work. They filed the order of conditions with the registry of deeds, and they never pursued the certificate of compliance.
I make a motion that we issue the certificate of compliance.
Second.
A motion and a second. Any additional questions?
Yeah. So that would fall under the building inspector, right? Realistically, because they finished the building. And
I guess side by side.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
He would have had to sign off on it.
Right.
At some point.
Sure.
That would have been Joe Lawrence at that time.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. Roll call.
Karen Smigel, aye.
Oh, Renee Driscoll, aye.
Matt Talbot, aye.
Joe Duwan, aye.
Bonnie Mindy's, aye.
Bob Camara, aye.
Okay. Thank you. All right.
I'll let you read that last one.
All right, and the final certificate of compliance request, certificate of compliance request by Byron Holmes, PE, representing Gliding Herm Shipbuilding, 1 Riverside Ave, Somerset, Mass., regarding the construction of a 16,400 square foot building with an associated stormwater controls under order of conditions 070-0298, issued on April 3rd, 1998. An amended order of conditions with the same, file number 070-0298, was issued on June 29, 1998, and was allowed to increase the building size to 24,000 square feet.
Okay. So on behalf of Judge Duclos, please find the requester for a certificate of compliance. This is from Byron Holmes as well. For an order of conditions issued on the notice of intent submitted for this project was for a 16,400 square foot building with associated stormwater controls. The order of conditions is on file with the Fall River Registry of Deeds, book 3402, page 124. An amended notice of intent under the same file number was submitted to the commission on June 29, 1998, and was subsequently approved. This allowed the increase of the building size to 24,000 square feet. This letter will serve to confirm that the work at this location was completed at the time of the original approval and is in substantial accordance with the approved plan. It is also noted that a second order of conditions was issued in 2007, which we just did, that allowed the erection of an addition to this building with added stormwater controls. A separate certificate of compliance is being submitted for that project. Well, it has been submitted for the project. Again, same.
Okay. Anybody have any questions about this? I think this is the first one. This even predates you and I, Ken.
Yeah.
If there are no more questions, I will entertain a motion to issue the certificate of compliance. That's okay. We've got a motion.
Renee has a question.
Yep, that's okay. I'll just look for a second, and then we can entertain more questions.
Okay.
Thank you. Yep, please, Renee.
Oh, I just answered my own question in my mind.
Okay. All right. Glad to be here.
I won't even put in
all the
context.
Right.
That. All right.
No problem. All right. There are no additional questions. Roll call vote.
Darren Smigel, aye. It just looks like they're really expanding it. That's all.
Well, over time.
Is that?
Is it over time?
They've really expanded it.
Oh, they are. Okay.
That work's been done now for quite a while.
Over 20 years.
Oh, wow. Okay. All right. Renee Driscoll, aye.
Matt Talbot, aye.
Joe Duar,
aye.
Dr. Vera, aye.
Yeah, like you said, they would be selling it by.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. You should try it one day.
We'll move on to the minutes now. I'd entertain a motion to waive the reading of the minutes of September 20th. Thank you.
Second.
All right, motion on second. All in favor of waiving the reading? Can I have a motion to approve the minutes of September 20th? I'll entertain a motion.
Second. So move.
No, who made it?
I made it. Renee seconded it.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Did anybody have any questions, changes?
No.
Okay. Everybody's names are spelled right. All right. A roll call vote.
Darren Smigel, aye.
Renee Driscoll, aye.
Matt Talbot, aye.
I'm probably supposed to abstain, right, on the minutes because I do them. I
know.
I approve my minutes.
If you weren't there,
I approve my minutes. Right. I was never sure about that. Okay, I approve.
And Kamara, aye.
If you weren't there, you can still do them if you've read them, but you cannot offer any changes.
Okay. All right.
Thanks for the clarification.
Yes, thank you.
George, got a question.
Any new business or old business, Tim?
The site, well, the stipends or you should be getting them soon.
Okay.
We had a clerk was out this weekend for a longer period of time, and it would have been done last week, but she wasn't here. So I apologize for that.
Did they make it this calendar year or no?
You should get them next week.
Okay.
You should get them next week. Just keep your eyes on your direct deposit.
Sure. I know, I forget to do that.
On Whetstone Hill, does everybody know where the Morris Preserve is?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay, well, on it's all wide open. It's a lawn that the highway department cuts.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
On the other side, there's also a lawn that they cut, but we don't see it because it's overgrown with prickers and all that nuisance vegetation. They have the equipment now, the highway department, to be able to clear and maintain that. If anybody wants to go take a look before we do anything, but this is the kind of work that they like to do in the winter because there's no vegetation on any of this stuff, and if the ground is firm enough, it's easy for the equipment to get out there. They just want to make it one parcel again and clear out all that stuff. It's going to look better. And the more that stuff creeps in, as we all know, you know, and it gets put off to another day, and then we have...
Yeah, but they've been cleaning up areas in town that knows that machine.
Yeah, they just got it. That's the same machine, if you guys remember, when we had Steve Madden here from Elm Street, and we were talking about going around the edges of all that property to clean it up, so that it's the same machine.
Okay.
I mean, the only question I have is, you know, the way the vegetation is grown now, is it, you know, is there anything wet in there, any wildlife considerations?
Or? I have no indication of that. This is all fluid. I mean, Chris just pulled me aside and asked me. Okay. So let me look.
Yeah, is it going to disrupt any wildlife?
No, it shouldn't, because it's...
Nothing put in there?
What it's like is, okay, does everybody know where Bob lives?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. You know how between your yard and the next one down, getting closer to Route 6?
Yep.
You've got like that swath of woods in between. It should have been a paper street, but because nothing was done to it, it just kept growing and it's just established itself. That's what's beginning to happen over there, and it looks awful. Just, you know, it's something that we can do and get it cleaned up. I'm all in favor of doing it, but, you know, if you guys... I'll certainly look at the maps to make sure that there's nothing in there that needs to be protected, and if there is, then we will.
Okay. Good. Sure. That's good.
I noticed they cleared the corner of South and...
I noticed that, too.
Dublin Riverside there.
I noticed it after it was done.
I knew they were going to clean up some of it because it was obstructed.
Well, it was blocking the stop sign.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I know they cleaned out like a half.
They got, you know, just, they got a little aggressive. believe it or not, the phone calls that I've gotten, not one of them have been negative. They've all been like, oh, my God, it's so nice to be able to come down there and be able to see. And it is Phragmites. They're going to all be back next year. Mm-hmm. So they didn't uproot anything. They just kind of weed-whacked it down. And like I said, and Chris told me, he says, I had a couple of these guys that just went a little too far. And can't put it back now.
I think I ended up talking to Chris.
About the water levels?
Yeah. And that culvert, he said the culvert is state property. They can't do anything about it, but it just seems like somebody can look in it to see if it's obstructed. You know, that's all.
True.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It certainly is a whole different...
I did tell him when you called me.
...velocity of flow going through that culvert, you know, so...
You're talking about the new culvert?
Yeah, but
yeah,
like
yeah,
Chris,
yeah.
Chris, Christine Wardell was still alive.
We kind of like, me and Chris, we kind of agree that, you know, could it have been a little bigger? Perhaps sometimes it could have been. That water does get up real close to the top of that culvert, but that was engineered.
Well, the other culvert, the one that goes to the used-to-be skating rink, That,
the one that what?
The culvert that was placed.
The marsh.
The marsh.
Okay, all right.
You know, that the water through there used to rip through there, but now it just kind of...
That's because everything's just growing up, and it's just...
And that's the one, I think it was he that I spoke to, because there was a highway department.
I'm not sure that one's even working properly anymore.
Well, that's the point. You know,
yeah, that was the one that the state paid to have that put in.
Yeah.
As long as the town agreed that they were going to let the marsh go back to a salt marsh, not a freshwater marsh. And it's not letting enough salt water in.
Well, that's the point.
And we have phragmites, and there's no salt marsh over there. It's just a series of little streams.
I said to him, I said, it seems like something's obstructing it and not allowing the water to flow freely. And yeah. Whoever I spoke to, you know, was...
Well, he knows about it. There's been discussion.
Yeah. So, just so does he not want to take a look at it?
You know, who?
Chris. Does he
no, he's going to take a look at it. Yeah, I don't know if there's any changes that need to be made, but there's been some talks.
That's state.
And we don't know what we can do. Yeah. Do we need permission from the state to go in there and do anything because they're the ones that put it in, or are they kind of like, all right, we did it. We did what we said you were supposed to do. You guys did what you were supposed to do. Did it maybe not work out the way everybody hoped? I don't know, but if that's a process we're going to get into, then we're at the very beginning, and I'm not.
Yeah.
So can I, one more question. The person I spoke to just happened to be in his truck at that parking lot when I was taking a walk. So I don't know if it was Chris, but it was a highway department person.
A white truck?
White truck, yeah.
Did he have like a red beard?
He didn't ask for
it. Yeah. Did he have a mask on?
I don't know. I had
no, I didn't have a mask. I'd be surprised if it was...
So anyway, my whole thing is that, you know, it's the whole environment's changed over time.
It's been a topic of discussion, that I can tell you. I don't know what more, but if anything does go on over there, we certainly will.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's been discussed as far as how well that culvert is actually working.
And there's some talk that they would like to have the marsh back for skating. So
there's been talk of that since they closed it.
Yeah, that's true too.
Yeah. That'd be so cool if that was... Yeah.
Well, whoever I spoke to told me that he thought the marsh was just all fresh water now because he thought nothing was coming in from the estuary side through the culvert.
And that's something that'll have to be determined. Yeah. You know, I spoke to him about it, and he said he was going to look into it.
Okay. So just keep us surprised of that.
If you had called me... You had called me and told your concerns about the amount of water, and I let him know. And
it just was coincidental. I was taking a walk, and there was this truck from the highway department, and I just went to, spoke with the guy, whoever he was.
Thanks, Karen.
Yeah.
We'll just follow up and let us know if there's any action.
Yep, okay, I will. I definitely will. But like I said, all I can do is look. Nothing can be... Nothing can be touched.
Oh, absolutely.
So, you know, this is my thing. The water on the estuary side, when you on the culvert at South Street, when you said it's really at the top all the time.
Where they what?
You know, the culvert on South Street, when you said the water seems to be at the top all the time, at the estuary side.
Does it need to be at the top all the time?
Well, the water at high tide is really high now.
Yes.
Is it because the culvert going to the marsh is obstructed?
I don't know. I don't know if it's obstructed.
Yeah.
I don't know if there's more fresh water than there is salt water, and it's kind of created a...
No, I've watched it.
Okay, then I would probably agree with what you said.
Yeah. Okay.
I don't know if this is new business, but do we have a building inspector?
We do.
We do,
so
okay.
We have a new building inspector. He started today. It was a week ago today.
Oh, okay.
His name is Carl Pizarro. He's from New Bedford. Mm-hmm. And so far, so good.
Good. Okay.
Did he work for the city of New
Bedford? He did. He was one of the inspectors that the city of New Bedford had.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
I know quite a few of those folks from back in the day, but the name doesn't really help. Okay, I've talked to the stipend, you took care of the minutes, nothing else?
No, so I have one thing in the wings, it's just an RDA,
okay.
And we're not, there's no, you know, there's no pressure, so
if we want to, do we want to pick a date tonight?
Lock it down, and then if...
Then they don't have to be surveying everybody.
Sure. The 17th is the holiday next month, so is the 10th too soon, or the 24th work better? I don't know what makes sense.
24th, I'll be away.
Oh. Lucky you.
I hope it's for a good time.
All right, so...
The last name?
I don't know that we need to rush it for the 10th.
Okay.
Thursday to Monday. Right.
You're not going to be around the 24th?
Yeah, I'll be around.
Oh, you will be?
I won't be around the week before.
The week before, so Martin Luther King week. You're
right.
Okay. So we can do the 24th or the 31st.
Does that work? Pretty much everybody? Okay.
31st is good for me because I will not... I'll be retired.
Oh, you'll be retired?
That's right.
Why don't we do that?
The 31st
day. Why don't we do that in celebration of her retirement? That way she'll be here at 10 of 6.
Okay. Yeah, no more to your eyes.
Poor Karen.
Poor Karen. I do have a question. We had talked about you a while back. We had that list of the conservation areas.
Yep.
And I offered to do it up pretty. Do you have that?
I'll get it for you.
Okay, and I'll make either a brochure or something, or we'll come up with something. Okay, all right.
Yep.
Okay. It's winter months and COVID. I
something for you. All for that. Okay. If nobody else has anything additional, I will entertain a motion to close the meeting.
So moved.
So a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Have a second. All right. Roll call vote.
Ladies say second.
While you're still employed, we'll retire, Ken.
Roll call vote.
Oh, Ken Spiegel. Renee Driscoll, aye.
Matt Talbot, aye.
Joe Duarte, aye.
Bonnie Mendes, aye.
Bob Camara, aye.
Guy Duarte.
Thank you.
I always did that in the end.